Now I'd like to speak about how knowledge of formulations plays into proper measuring of pesticide products. Now, there's a couple things that are important to know. In our country, in our kitchens, we measure everything by volume. We use measuring cups for solids like flour and sugar, but we also use them for liquids like water and milk and wine. So we tend to forget that there's a big difference between a fluid ounce and a dry ounce. And we also tend perhaps to forget that dry weight or a dry ounce is density dependent. And so 4 ounces of one material won't take up the same amount of space as 4 ounces of another. All right, here's one illustration. There are 4 ounces by dry weight of 3 different materials in these jars. But you can see that 4 ounces of Epsom salts does not take up the same amount of space as 4 ounces of table salt. And that's because table salt is more dense. Again, 4 ounces by dry weight in all 3 of these jars. Alternatively, here are 4 fluid ounces of red dyed water. Again, not the same volume of material in any of these. So the first thing is, make sure you know if you want liquid ounce or dry ounce. And if you want dry ounce, make sure you're using the proper measuring device for the product. Okay. Now, here are, with kitty litter and green water, some pesticide examples. These are 3 measuring devices designed for 3 different dry flowable pesticide products, and all have been filled to the same 4 ounce line, but as you can see, there are different amounts of kitty litter by volume in each of these 3 jars. And here is a liquid product, 4 fluid ounces, which doesn't align with any of the above. So again, make sure you know if it's fluid or dry, and if it's dry, make sure you're using the device that was calibrated for that product based on its density. Here are 2 tubes for 2 different products, and I have put 2 ounces of dry milk in there to show you what the difference looks like. If you would grab this tube for this product or vice versa, your amount would be off. And if you go to all the trouble to calibrate your equipment plus or minus 5%, and then you use the wrong measuring device for a dry flow of a product, or heaven forbid, grab a liquid, a device meant to measure liquids and use it for dries, you're going to be off by a country mile, and all your hard work in calibrating your equipment and doing the math to calculate how much you should put in the tank is all for nothing because you've measured wrong. All right, some containers are clearly marked as to what they're intended to measure. For example, this one says right on it, U.S. fluid ounces, and that's what it's intended to be used for. This one, you can look all day long, and it says ounces, but it doesn't tell you what kind of ounces. So, in my opinion, this is in the recycling bin. Or you could pour in liquid and see if it lines up. In other words, measure 4 ounces of liquid in one container, pour it in here and see if it comes up to the 4 line. And then you'll know it's intended for liquid measure. This container, nice as it is, says ounces and milliliters. Now, it doesn't say what kind of ounces, but because I know milliliters is a liquid measure and I know this product is a liquid product, I can deduce or assume that it's intended for liquid measure, but it's not as well marked as it could be. Alternatively, here's one that's very plain. T-Jet calibration container says right on there, U.S. fluid ounces and milliliters. Etched, even if you spill something that eats into, or not eats into, but washes off the writing, you still have the marks on the container. This is a nice thing. Now, unfortunately, a chemical company took this exact same mold and used it to indicate amounts of a dry flowable product. And it says on here, use for Sahara. Most people are also going to use it for liquid measure, which could ultimately result in some confusion if folks aren't careful. Here's another example, same exact mold. This was intended or is intended for fluid ounces. This one says right on it, volumetric divides, use this guide for nothing but Streamline herbicide. And it's a dry flowable product. And these measurements indicate dry weight. So you got to be careful. If you grab this one for that or that one for this, you aren't going to be happy with the results. Now, one more time. The devices that come with the dry flowable or water dispersible granule formulation products are intended, they're product specific. They should be used for that product and that product only. They say on there that they're only to be used for a certain product. They tell you to dispose of them after you use them, not to hoard them, not to use them for other products. And they also give a volumetric accuracy of plus or minus 7% or maybe even 10%. And they tell you if you need to be more accurate than that, you should weigh the material. And I will say that if you go to the trouble to calibrate your equipment and do the math to figure out how much to put in the tank, you don't want to make a measurement mistake by either using a rough or an improper measuring device. They do have codes on here that mean something to somebody. This one, for example, is a bunch of letters and numbers, and it says 09209. That's probably for this batch of material. I have seen some of these that you pick up two exactly identical trade name on the tube, but the lettering's a little different, or maybe even the color's a little different, and when you hold them up, you see the lines don't match up. And that's because the batches have different carriers or have been reformulated, and so you don't want to hoard even for the same product. You don't want to use a three-year-old tube for a brand newly purchased product because they may not match up and you may not get the right amount of material into your spray tank.